Harmonica Warrior from YouTube asks, could you use an electric juicer for juicing the wheatgrass juice? Yes, you can. I use a manual. I've been getting used to using an electric juicer for the last month. It's a lot more convenient and a lot easier on the arm. Manual ones sell for $75, $100. You can go for an electric juicer. They start around 2.25, 2.5 for like an Omega. Samson, $400. You can go up to a Wheatatini for $800, $900 commercial. I'm more of a purist where I use the hand crank or do it manually. The lights go out, you're still juicing. You can get a long list of suppliers on the internet. I had another question. Could you use artificial lights such as light bulbs, etc.? Since I come from Scotland, it's a rare occasion we get a good sunny day. It's always nice to put the wheatgrass juice out for the sun once it's 4 or 5 inches tall. Not younger. Full strength sun is not good for it. I use fluorescent tubes myself indoors and 40 waters sunlight, full spectrum, and I haven't had much light luck with LED or these new CFL lights. I think they're dangerous. They give off bad radiation. But I would suggest just, you go to Home Hardware, you can pick up a light fixture as well as two plant aquarium lights, $35, $40, and you can grow 4 trays, enough for yourself and your friends. And that's about it for that question. Bud Smoker, THC, from YouTube asks, I was wondering if you knew complete nutrient content list of the wheatgrass juice. So, and I found some nutritional analysis. It's at this time over 3,800 nutrients have been identified in food, with countless unidentified nutrients potentially available. Wheatgrass juice is well contains a small amount of a broad spectrum of nutrients. When consumed as fresh or frozen, it is raw, living, and highly bioavailability nutrition because the juicing process breaks down the indigestible fibers and releases their contents. Raw and living foods hold 3 advantages over processed supplements. Raw foods are more complete as they contain a broad spectrum of known nutrients. Better still, they contain a broad spectrum of unknown nutrients because they have not been heated, cooked, dried, powdered, oxidized, canned, irradiated, pasteurized, or bottled. Most biochemical reactions are complex and need several ingredients to occur. The optimum fuel for the body is more likely the combination of many nutrients rather than a large amount of a single nutrient. So then we go on to have a look at what we've got in the nutritional, just to give you an idea. This is the first page. Starts off with ash, calories, carbohydrates, chlorophyll, dietary fiber, moisture, protein. Vitamins, it's got biotin, chlorine, folic acid, inositol, vitamin A, B1, B2, B3, B5, B6, B12. I believe it also has B17, B27. Vitamin C, ascorbic acid, vitamin D, E, and K. Minerals, it has calcium, iron, goes on, magnesium, phosphorus, potassium, selenium, sodium, zinc. Amino acids, big on amino acids, alanine, aspartate acid, casein, glutamic acid, glycine, histidine, goes on and on. L-arginine, L-lysinine, leucine, methionine. oh my goodness, proline, serines, serotonin, tryptophan, valine, phenylalanine, proline, loads of enzymes, amylase, lipase, protease, essential fatty acids. It's full spectrum nutrition. I believe in the principle of a little bit of everything is much better than a big concentrated effort, like a vitamin C or vitamin E, or just, you know, if you've got a bit of everything, there's a synergy that builds up in there, and it equals more than the actual values of what it is that you're consuming. So that's for our good buddy Bud Smoker, THC, from YouTube.